Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Anne's Church. Our Mass intention for today is for Ofelia Gonzalez.
Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good evening, everyone. My sisters and brothers, today our Holy Mother Church commemorates the memorial of Saint Padre Pio, a wonderful pastor, a pastor who reached out to many, many people, for he had a great love for neighbor and love for God. So during this Holy Mass, let us pray for his powerful intercession, and let's now acknowledge our sins and failures, and so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Kyrie, eleison. Christe, eleison. Kyrie, eleison.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who by a singular grace gave the priest Saint Pius a share in the cross of his Son, and by means of his ministry renewed the wonders of your mercy, grant that through his intercession we may be united constantly to the sufferings of Christ and so brought happily to the glory of the resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Every word of God is tested. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him. Add nothing to his words, lest he reprove you, and you will be exposed as a deceiver. Two things I ask of you. Deny them not to me before I die. Put falsehood and lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need, lest, being full, I deny you, saying, "Who is the Lord?" Or being in want, I steal, and profane the name of my God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp to my feet.
Remove from me the way of falsehood, and favor me with your law. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Your word, O Lord, endures forever. It is firm as the heavens. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. From every evil way I withhold my feet, that I may keep your words. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Through your precepts I gain discernment, therefore I hate every false way. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Falsehood I hate and abhor, your law I love. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus summoned the 12 and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He said to them, "Take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money, and let no one take a second tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. And as for those who do not welcome you, when you leave that town, shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them." Then they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and curing diseases everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, today's saint, Padre Pio, is being known all over the world as the Capuchin friar who had the stigmata and who was canonized by Pope Saint John Paul II in the year 2002. And at this canonization, Pope Saint John Paul II beautifully said that Padre Pio was a generous dispenser of divine mercy. And my friends, as I was trying to read and reflect the autobiography and the biography of Padre Pio, I came across his early childhood. He was One of eight children in a poor peasant family, born in the year 1887 in a small Italian village. His parents named him Francisco in honor of Saint Francis of Assisi. And Francisco was very devout, even as a young boy. At an early age, he felt drawn to priesthood. He wanted to become a priest. And he became a Capuchin novice at the age of 16 and took the name Pio in honor of the patron Pope Saint Pius V. And after 7 years of his formation in the seminary, he was ordained a priest. And then for 50 years at a monastery, he was much sought after spiritual advisor, a confessor, an intercessor, whose life was completely devoted to the Holy Eucharist and prayer. And he was in solitude. And Padre Pio's love for the Holy Eucharist was experienced as a burning fire. He had a great love for the Most Holy Eucharist. And he said, it would be easier for the earth to carry on without the sun than without the Holy Mass. And filled with love of God, a love of neighbor, Padre Pio demonstrated a remarkable zeal for his vocation, which he considered a call to work for the spiritual well-being of others. And he was a man of deep prayer, deep piety, and prudence. And Padre Pio had 5 rules for spiritual growth, or in other words, he had 5 maxims for living a devout Catholic Christian life. The first is weekly confession. The second is daily communion. And the third one is spiritual reading. The fourth one is meditation. And the fifth one is examination of conscience, daily examination of conscience. So when the news spread about Padre Pio, who had been working miracles, people flocked to him. And to those asked, do you perform miracles? He simply said, I'm only a friar who prays. So indeed, the Lord worked many, many miracles through his powerful intercession. And numerous miracles have been attributed to his intercession. And my friends, he had also various other gifts and charisms, like bilocation, healings by touch, an ability to read the hearts of people. The special charism he had was for spiritual direction and the sacrament of reconciliation. He was sitting in the confessional hours together, listening to people's sins and forgiving them and giving them absolution. And his sanctity made a great impact on all those who came in contact with him. The good Lord singled him out for the most significant graces, especially the stigmata, a representation of his great wounds. While praying before Christ on September 20th in the year 1918, Padre Pio received stigmata. He is the first priest ever to be so blessed, and thus he became the first stigmatic priest of the church and remained the focal point of edification for numerous believers. So as we commemorate the memorial of Saint Padre Pio today, may we ask him, may we ask for his powerful intercession in order that we may always live in fidelity to Christ. We may live in fidelity to the church and in charity to our brothers and sisters, and may his holy life and sanctity enlighten each one of us to strive to be fully human in our way of life. Praise to be the holy name of Jesus. Amen. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful. Relying on God's mercy and love as a source of all we need, we now offer our prayers to the Lord.
That the word of God alive in his church may raise up more missionaries and charity workers for the gospel, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That leaders of nations may be moved by the Holy Spirit to depend more on God than on worldly power, let us pray to the Lord. Lord,
hear our prayers.
That those who are overwhelmed by difficulties may be blessed with the Lord's consolation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our faith community may continue to grow in faith and love as we work to spread the good news of the kingdom, of God's kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have died may be given eternal refuge with Christ in his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also pray for Ofelia Gonzalez. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, gracious God, our refuge and shield, grant what we need for our journey of faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
By the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard you people cry. I who dwelt in dark and sin, my hand will sing.
My friends, that a sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of Saint Padre Pio, so that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon and mercy, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as in the festival of Saint Padre Pio, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are
holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of our faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and today's Saint, Padre Pio, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. The Savior's command and found by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Let's now offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us all safe for eternal life. Amen. Thank you.
its plans and schemes. Give me nothing more than your love and grace. This alone, O God, are enough for me. When the darkness falls on my final days, take the very breath that sang your praise. Give me nothing more than your love and grace. This alone, O God, are enough for me.
My friends, may we now do the act of spiritual communion for those unable to receive Holy Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Saint Padre Pio, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.
And have a blessed evening, everyone. God bless you all.
Thank you, Father.